Okay, here we go. What I want to do is get some of this, tape this off so it's going to be a window scene. Get our glue all inside of this brush here. Just tap it all into this color so you've got plenty of color. And then this all out. Sorry, I had to turn the fan down. This joker was trying to get so hot that it was just making everything dry out. take a little bit of this cloud color, a little bit of white. Just throw some color up in here. Throw some clouds. And maybe just a little bit right here as well. There we go. Okay. Just go right down these clouds, the very base of them. So we got our nice little clouds in here. I had to have a couple more dark things up in here. Most of that's going to get covered up. Do a quick brush wash. And just beat the devil out of it. So, what we're going to do now is we're going to take a light blue color here. Maybe a touch of black with this. Now this is just a filbert brush. Thank you.
a touch darker. Okay. I normally do this with the fan brush, but this will work. Bring this one out in front of this one. And maybe I just set up in front of this one. Take a fan brush. Back up in here as well. A little bit of snow on there. Now, take this dark color again. And we're going to come right down here. Thank you.
let's take a little bit of this
brown and blue color and just make a lightish, a light color here. Right, right in here. We do have, I think we'll go ahead and go in here. Go ahead and bring another, go ahead and bring a tree up here. This one's a nice big tree. So let's get that clean back off. Switch over to another fan brush. I got a couple of them here I can work with. So let's get a little bit of that blue, nice blue color. I'll be right back. This time we're going to make a nice crystal blue. Take this a little bit here. Thank you. there's some. So throw some more white. Okay, here we go. Now, I normally use water-based oils, but water soluble oils, but I ran out of that just a minute ago, so gotta throw a little bit of white up in here. I just don't have any more of the white, so I'm gonna just use this regular oil color to put a little bit of white here and there on these trees. You can tell it's kind of a sticky type of white. A little stickier than what I had. Now what we're going to do, I take my knife. I have some Van Dyke Brown. I go ahead and put some black. Make that black, make that color nice and dark. And we're going to just come here maybe just throw a tree in here. It's just gonna go right off the top.
Okay.
Come back here, do the back side of it. So there we go. Let me wipe my knife off. Just come in here and get a little bit of this white. And just come in here. Put a quick shadow on this tree. And on the back of this tree may have a little bit of blue, just to show a little bit of a shadow behind this tree. Okay, there we go. I'm gonna just wipe that back off. Come back in here. I'll just throw a couple bushes up in here. Maybe these bushes just come right around. Knife, scratch in a couple sticks and twigs. And you guys hang in there, because I want to show you what this looks like when I pull this off. So this takes a little bit of time to get done, but what we're gonna do here is go ahead and bring that color and fill that on down here. Maybe a little bit of that bluish color. Okay, now
all that white.
Let's get some more of this. Some of this white. Look at these bushes. Maybe there's some, you know, sticks and twigs just kind of bending over here and there. Little bushes hanging up in here. I may be back in here. So, wipe that brush back off, and then gotta do just hopefully we get a little bit more out of this tube, because hold on 1 second, guys. Okay, guys, I'm back. I had to get some water to just basically get some tree branches and stuff in here. And, you know. Maybe a couple sticks here and there. Still sticking up. Maybe a couple down in here. You know, because this stuff is going to still... you will still see a few sticks and stuff, even in the snow. Okay, so... And truthfully, a nervous hand actually works really well. Bob Ross said that years ago, and surprisingly it does work, because every time I go to put a stick or a twig on, my hand wants to shake every time I get near it. So, and you'll probably find that out too. There is a stabilizer stick you could use, kind of a pole that goes up in front of this. Let you be able to stabilize your hand while you do the little flicks and stuff. So we're just throwing a couple of sticks and twigs up here. We're gonna do just a couple little more, and then you'll get to see. And I tell you, sometimes a branch will come up. And it'll actually just loop right around. So, see, you can make your tree branches do whatever you want. Right now, I'm going to put a little bit of snow on here.
I wanted to clean that liner brush because that's one brush you really don't ever want to leave paint set in. So now what I'm going to do is take one of these fan brushes and I'm going to get just a nice glob of white, and right up here where our tape is, maybe. You know, maybe the snow sets right on that windowsill like that. Maybe a little bit here. And you notice that on your house sometimes, when you look out the window, the snow catches right on the edge of your windowsill. So even here, it's kind of just setting up on the ledge, up on your window ledge. So right in here where the where that sets, right on that window ledge. Try to make that one a little more profound. Okay, now are you guys ready? We're gonna pull this off and let you guys see what it looks like. I mean, I don't know if it worked out right or not, because you never know till you peel it off. So, outside edges. Peeling off. I think that turned out okay.